Imagine telling your computer what to do, and it actually does it. Navigating files, launching programs, even summarizing your documents. That's exactly what a computer use agent can do. In this video, I'll show how you can build one yourself from scratch with just a couple of dependencies in under 1 hour. Sounds complicated? I promise you it's not. By the end, you'll have your very own bash terminal agent powered by NVIDIA Nemotron. The code is linked below, but before I walk you through it, let me give you a quick look at what this agent can do. I'll start the agent from the terminal. It shows which model it is running, then waits for my prompt. You can also see the current working directory. First, I'll ask it to scan the directory tree and list the top 5 largest files. The model is in thinking on mode, so when you see thinking on screen, it's actually generating responses internally. We just keep it hidden to maintain a clean view. The agent combines the sort, find, and head commands, asks for confirmation, then displays the result. Next, I'll have it check the kernel log file to find the cause of the most recent system crash. After confirming the read command, it summarizes the root cause. So, what makes an agent different from a chatbot? A chatbot just replies, whereas an agent understands your goal and figures out a way to execute it. Let's now unpack the agent's architecture. It's actually very simple. The system has two main parts. First, the bash class, which tracks the working directory, enforces an allow list, and only runs commands you approve. Second, the agent, which is powered by Nemotron. This component interprets the intent, plans all the steps, and calls the bash class to execute your intent. Note that the agent can repeatedly invoke the functions from the bash class to execute your intents. Here's everything that you need to follow along. You'll need access to the NVIDIA Nemotron Nano model, either deployed locally or in the cloud. You'll also need an operating system with the bash terminal. This can be Ubuntu, macOS, or Windows subsystem for Linux. Additionally, your Python environment must be version 3.10 or above with the OpenAI package installed. Optionally, if you'd like to use LangGraph, make sure the LangChain OpenAI and LangGraph packages are also installed. Lastly, you'll need about an hour of spare time. Now let's take a look at the code. Here are the main files. The config file defines the system setup, the LLM powering the agent and its parameters, plus the agent configuration, things like the allowed commands and the system prompt. Next is the bash file, which enables the agent to execute the commands through the terminal. The bash class here exposes two public functions. Exec bash command takes a command, checks it against the allow list, and then passes it to the private run bash command function for execution. The second public function tells the LLM how to execute the exec bash command function. Command execution happens inside the private run bash command function, which takes as input the target command to execute in the terminal. This command is wrapped with a marker and pwd, then run using Python subprocess.run. This captures both output and error streams and updates the working directory. If there's no output, we return a success message. If there's an error, it's caught and returned cleanly. The function always returns a dictionary with output, error information, and the current working directory, everything that the agent needs for its next step. Next is the helpers file, which introduces two small abstractions. The messages class tracks the conversation history and stores the system prompt, user inputs, assistant responses, and tool call results. This is necessary to keep the context consistent during interactions with our agent. The LLM class handles sending requests to Nemotron and parsing the responses. Now the agent loop, built from scratch. That implementation is inside this file. The structure is simple. Take user input, send it to Nemotron, and check if the response includes a tool call. If it does, route it to the exec bash command function, then feed the results back and repeat. If not, return the reply and wait for the next input from the user. Finally, here's the same loop built with LangGraph. We tie together the Nemotron model, the bash class, and the system prompt using LangGraph's create-react-agent function. This returns an agent object that handles user input, command execution, and results routing automatically, greatly simplifying the logic and error handling.
And that's it, your very own computer-use agent built from the ground up. The same principles discussed here apply to far more advanced agents. So try experimenting with it, see what's possible. Check out the resources below or connect with me in the developer forums or on Discord to share what you build. I can't wait to see what you come up with.